Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. It's early part of September, and the next stage has come along. Blossoms have blossomed, and just like in the spring when the tulips are done, you clip them off, same with your perennials. These are balloon flowers. Let me get one that's still open. They're beautiful. They form little balloons that suddenly pop open and have five beautiful petals. And look at that beautiful inside there. But they're done. You can see they're all trying to go to seed. Well, I don't want them to go to seed. I want them to put their energy into their roots. So I'm nipping them off. And not only does it make your garden area look more orderly and cleaned up, it gives the plant the energy it needs to go for next year. Now, I did notice that I have blue, kind of purpley ones. I have white ones. There are pinkish ones. But then I realized that I now have some striped ones. I don't remember planting those there. So whether they're cross-pollinating and hybridizing themselves, I don't know. But I thought that was kind of neat. So I may leave that one and collect the seeds from this one. There's another one, just one over there too, which makes me think they are blending themselves. Another thing I cut off was this goldenrod. Now, this isn't the wild goldenrod you see blooming out in the fields. This is a more tame one. We bought it as a plant. I wasn't sure if what I had in the garden was that until it finally started blooming. But it's way too large, and I had to wait until early this morning to get it because the bumblebees really love it, and I didn't want to get in the midst of the bumblebees.
Well, we've had so many wasps this year.
It's bad for wasps and amazing. Yellow jackets and all those bad ones. I shouldn't say bad, but the ones that hurt and do a lot of harm. Honeybees and even bumblebees, really, you know, if you don't bother them, they leave you alone. But the yellow jackets and the hornets are a whole different story. So we have to be careful with those. Our son got stung on his hand and it swelled up so that he couldn't even make a fist with his hand. It was just swollen from here down. And Benadryl ice packs, Benadryl cream, you know, just it had to go through a system. So be careful, be aware. Another thing is it's possibly time to start thinking about the shape you want your rose bushes to take care of at some point. The giant hibiscus, the flowers are getting smaller, as you can see. They used to be dinner plate size. Now they're maybe saucer size. These are the secondary blooms now. The first initial blooms are gone, and these are the little ones coming up. You can see where all of the old ones used to be. And these are the seed pods that are forming. And these are prolific seed bearers. If you want seeds from them, you leave a couple on. I hesitate to take off any of them at this point because I don't want to miss the last little blooms possible. I'll chop them down later and not worry about the seeds.
Well, they'll continue until almost the frost, right?
They will, yes. The flowers will be smaller, and you know that's to be expected. But
it's always amazing because it's over 6 foot tall, and they die down to the ground totally. And you wait till late spring before they even resurface.
It's mid June around here before they even start coming up, and that they can grow that much and produce such abundance of flowers is amazing.
Yeah,
that's why they're so spectacular.
Well, considering each flower comes out every day, and then it dies, and then a new one comes out, and it's amazing.
Yes. Now, there are other plants like the echinacea, which most of them have now bloomed, and you see these flower heads. Now, we don't have a problem with these flower heads because the birds love them. You can see how they've picked them clean. These have no seeds in them. These are just the empty heads now, where the seeds are gone. This goldfinches love these. They just, you see them flying in the yard, you know they're after these. So I might leave these on a little longer so they can pick them clean. Then I'll chop those off. I don't like to chop my perennials down way to the ground. I like to leave my perennials at least this tall so that they can catch leaves and anything that else, snow that might be blowing around later, because that will help their roots be...
Kind of insulate them.
Insulated, correct, from the cold, freezing, and then the sun thawing them out, and then freezing and thawing. So I let their own stalks be their insulation trap. The mums are coming, as you can see. Nice big bushes of them. These are some of the balloon flowers that I chopped off the other day, so they're looking nice now. The hostas, many of them have already bloomed. Some still have their last flowers showing. Yeah, their last hurrah. I will cut those stalks off. I don't want those up there. They get droopy and sloppy, and then you can't appreciate the beauty of the leaves. So I'll take those off as they mature. But it's just, you know, it's the next phase. And if you start getting sad about, oh my gosh, all the flowers are gone, you just have to appreciate each season for the beauty that it brings. Right now, with the mums coming and the gladiolas blooming, and then the hibiscus, the purple hibiscus over there is in full bloom, the sunflowers. Here's some more hibiscus behind me. This is our hibiscus tree. And then of course there's the zinnias that are going. Now this year I have not been cutting off the old heads. Usually I do that, but I noticed the goldfinches were eating there too. So I might start doing it, because that'll just encourage the secondary blossoms to start forming also. And it'll look brighter without all the old heads showing. Geraniums are about to show some of their most beautiful color, because it's cool today, but it's going to get hot again. They kind of like the cooler, sunny weather that the fall brings, and sometimes in the fall we get more rain, so they enjoy that. Unfortunately, this is not a rain year, and I've heard that they're now considering this part of Wisconsin to be in a drought again, after a spring where it was perfect. But, you know, that's, each year is different, so you have to work with it. But you just, you know, enjoy what you have when it blooms, and enjoy the creatures that come with it. The other day we were out here with our friend, and hummingbird just flittering all around, drinking out of the hummingbird feeder, entertaining us with delightful wonder.
Well, it came up, I'd say, within maybe 6 inches of Ginger, and
yes,
you know, she was just looking at it, and it was looking at her, and it kept flittering,
yes,
around, and then came back.
And not only did we hear the humming, the spectacular humming that you hear and you think is a giant bee, but also it was chirping, which, mm-hmm, I didn't know hummingbirds chirp, but it definitely had a little chirpy sound to it.
Yep.
So
they're beautiful.
They are beautiful, and they're just a blessing to watch. Well, I hope you're enjoying your late summer, early fall. Appreciate every blossom you can, knowing that come winter, they won't be here if you live in the northern climates, but each season has its beauty. If you'd love to share some of your pictures with us or your stories about what's happening in your neck of the woods, we'd love to hear from you. If you have a chance, give us a thumbs up and leave a comment or subscribe to us. That'd be even better. Thank you so much for watching. Bye for now.